things to come in our national sport as the baseball season gets underway. The spanking new Astrodome is the new $31 million home of the Houston Astros, a domed stadium that holds nearly 50,000 for a baseball game and more for conventions and meetings. The plastic ceiling makes it an all-weather stadium, but already there is trouble. Fielders have a time keeping their eye on high fly balls during daylight games. Research teams are working on the problem. The scoreboard is something. An opposition blast and it cries, tilt! The scoreboard is a $2 million item that's a show in itself. When the home team pulls something spectacular like scoring the winning runs, there's no holding that mechanical marvel in center field.
How you doing? My name is Samuel Barraza, also known as Big Tech Sam, local Houstonian. I have to say my favorite experience that I had here with the Astrodome was when me and my cousin were selling posters during the Houston Oilers playoffs against the Jets back in the 80s. I was on the corner of Fannin Street with my cousin where we were selling Warren Moon posters. Well, we heard the roar of the crowd all the way from the Dome all the way to Fannin Street, and we just wanted to be in the game so bad, but of course we didn't have the money to get in for playoff tickets or anything like that. You know, we just dreamed about being in there. Well, a gentleman drove up during the first quarter of the game and handed my cousin two tickets to the playoff game. So we grabbed them tickets. We couldn't believe that we had just gotten given two tickets to a playoff game. We ran all the way to the Dome. And when we got inside, it was electrifying just to hear the roar of the crowd, to see the field. The field was like neon green, you know, the turf there. And the players who were just glowing on the field. It was really a day that I'll never forget, and I know my cousin will never forget. But that's my best experience I've ever had here at the Astrodome. And one of the only ones, but it's something that I'll remember for the rest of my life. Love you, Blue, Houston Oilers. And now we are the Houston Texans, baby.
Hi, my name is Sue Olds. My favorite time in the Dome was watching Nolan Ryan pitch his last game in it, watching Earl Campbell run and play, because I was an Oilers season ticket holder, and there was just no stadium like it anywhere in the world, and there still isn't.
My name is Richard Gutierrez. I work for Ozarka Spring Water, and I used to deliver all the bottled water to the Houston Astros and the Houston Oilers in the 90s. Favorite memories are coming here as a kid and sitting in the press box with my godfather, who announced the games on a Spanish radio station, KLVL. Johnny Hernandez.
My name's Tim Driver from League City, Texas, and my favorite memory of the Dome is being able to service the very original computer that ran the scoreboard in the back. It was a analog computer, ran on Mylar punch tape.
My name is Juan. My favorite memory was coming here with the family. Gonna go see all the livestock show and all the rodeo up here.
Favorite performance?
Selena. Had to be.
One of my favorite memories was the Texas Jam back in 1982, summer of 82, with Point Blank, a Houston group, Joan Jett and the Blackheart, Sammy Hagar, Santana, and it ended up with Journey. One of the best shows out there, good times in the Astrodome.
What's your name?
Andy. My name is Andy.
Yeah, what's up? My name is Joe B, and I think my favorite memory of the Astrodome would probably be eating the nachos. Every time I come up here, eat a whole bunch of nachos and wait for foul balls and come with my baseball team and, you know, having a good time like that. Jose Cruz, Earl Campbell, my heroes, you know what I mean? Kept me in the mix, and that's what's up.
I'm Krista Cheatham, and my favorite memory of the Dome is George Strait in concert. Love him.
Hey, my name's Gary. My favorite memory is coming here with my family to see games. And we would see doubleheaders. We'd start at 4 o'clock in the afternoon and not leave till 11 o'clock at night. I loved it.
Which team?
I must have seen 100 games here. But, I mean, I've seen the Yankees here. I've seen the Dodgers. I've seen the Braves. I've seen them all. Great memories.
Name's John Hayes. I came here from a small hick town in Indiana, and coming here to see this Astrodome was... That scoreboard was unbelievable. It's like something out of a science fiction movie or something. It was great. I really admit it. It was great.
What was your favorite memory?
When the Oilers won.
Okay, every time they won.
Absolutely. And the Astros, too, of course. Okay. My wife used to work for the president of the Fox, Astrodome. Then she went to Fox Sports, so we got to get in some of the games free. So.
My name is Rudy Torres. I remember being a little kid coming with my dad, my brother, my uncle. And I hopped over the seats in the dome to go to the restroom, and in the process, I got caught. So the maintenance crew had to come, undo the chairs, get me out, and they put me on the big jumbotron and everything. And it was a great game. Astros won. I think we beat the Braves 4-1, but it was awesome.
My name is Susie Boyd, and Astrodome opened the year I graduated from high school. Yes, I'm dating myself. We also brought my husband's grandpa here. He was in his 80s, and we saw Elvis Presley at the Astrodome.
I'm Abigail, and my favorite memory is Selena. My parents took me to her concert, and I just remember being a kid screaming really loud. It was amazing.
Hi, my name is Jason Clark, and my favorite memories of the Dome are coming here with my dad when I was a kid, the first time I walked in, and seeing how huge it was, getting to go here with my Little League team, seeing the rodeos here, just every event that came through Houston that went to the Dome, it was awesome.
Hi, my name's Alex Barton with Outlaw Monster Truck, and my favorite memory of the Houston Astrodome is my dad actually took me to my first Monster Truck show in this building, and ever since then it sparked a dream to become the job of mine, and that dream is now becoming a reality as my truck is actually right behind you, sitting in front of the Astrodome, where I saw my first show when I was 2 years old.
My name is Alfred Juarez. This is my son AJ Juarez. My fondest memory was walking around trying to find my car after an Oilers game. And it was always just going in circles till you find your car, till everybody left. And that was one of my greatest memories.
I'm Alex Vasilakidis, one of the co-founders at Eighth Wonder Brewery, sitting here in front of the Astrodome, celebrating the 50th anniversary today. Actually sitting in some original seats that we picked up last year at the auction. We're serving Dome Foam today, which is paying homage. It's a play off the original Dome Foam served in the Astrodome, so super light, refreshing beer. Very excited about today. A lot of memories here. See, we share it with a lot of other people from Houston, and just excited to be a part of this. Favorite all-time memories? Well, you know, it might not be sporting, but it was definitely coming to the rodeo. I remember catching the last rodeo, I think it was 99, Bob Dylan, maybe 2000. And that was my last memory and therefore my fondest.
My name is Erica. My favorite memory was going there as a kid in fourth grade and watching the Astros win.
My name is Adam LaFrances. My favorite memory of the Astrodome was coming to see Billy Gilman at the rodeo, second to last one that they had here. Traveled all the way from Austin for that.
I'd say my favorite memory is when I got to kick a field goal inside the Astrodome about 1992 against the Oilers against the Chicago Bears. Missed the big 50-yarder for the big money, but I did nail a 30-yarder, won me a Nokia phone package. Great memories of the Astrodome. Bo Trower.
My name's Mike, and I remember Nolan Ryan's last game here, and he came back with the Rangers, and they retired his number.
My name is Luis Garcia. My favorite memory of the Astrodome is when we played the black and gold game in my high school senior year here, and we were at the on the field, the football field, and played the game.
What high school?
Sam Houston High School.
What year?
It was 1984.
Julie Pickett, Elvis Presley, 1970, and I'm a native Houstonian.
My name is Joe Espinosa from here in Houston. My first job was actually here at the Dome. I was a junior in high school selling peanuts and ice cream. Got to check out all the Astros game. That was Biggio's rookie year. And before that, I have to say, game one of the NLCS against the Mets, they won 1-0. And Mike Scott lit them up.
Hi, I'm Phaedra Langham, and I remember coming to the Dome and going to Astros games and popping cups in the stadium after games. Those paper cups made quite the sound. Loved it.
My name's Gary Shadwell. My favorite memory of the Astrodome is Elvis Presley, 1965.
My name's Jason Elmore. My favorite memory is being at the last game at the Dome, and we won and won the championship. The Astros, 1999.
Hello, I'm Haley. I've officially been with my mother to the last Astros game, the last concert in the Astrodome, and now the last public event. It's pretty awesome.
Hey, this is Tom Entwistle. My favorite memories of the Astrodome is being the Houston Astros DJ in the 80s at all of their games.
Hi, my name's Jerry Askey. I've driven Thunder Chicken, the new one. The original Thunder Chicken was ran back from the mid-80s to 1990, and it was down here in Astrodome in 88 and 89 competing against like Outlaw, Gravedigger, and the big names back in then for TNT Motorsports.
Larry Vasera here, native Houstonian, back at the Dome, hopefully not for the final viewing. A couple of memories. Well, one time when I was young and thin and had two real knees, they had a 10K run around the Dome, and you got to finish by running into the ramp, down to the AstroTurf, seeing yourself on the Jumbotron, and then passing out. The other was when they had the Texas Jam. KLOL used to bring in good rock bands all day long, drinking and, well, enjoying yourself till you couldn't enjoy yourself no more. I think I remember some of that. Great times in the Dome, hope we have some more. Bye, y'all.
My name is Mary Helen Belmarez, and my favorite memories are bringing my son and his friends to the baseball games and coming to the All-Star game and some of the World Series playoffs, the time they went.
The name is Jimmy Blitz. Born and raised in Houston, Texas. And here we are at the beautiful Astrodome for the 50th anniversary. My favorite memory is WrestleMania 17, being proud of the 69,743 fans who broke the record inside of that for the attendance record. Main event, The Rock versus Stone Cold. World Heavyweight Championship on the line. That's when Stone Cold turned face in the whole new era of that whole new turn in the World Wrestling Federation. And of course, we can't forget it being a refugee for all the Katrina victims that fled the city. Yeah. I'm going back to my sandwich now.
Hello, my name is Nick Perez, and I used to come when and cheer. I used to cheer for Daryl Strawberry. I would holler out, Daryl, Daryl, Daryl. And then the whole stadium would start saying, Daryl, Daryl, Daryl. It was fantastic.
Hello, my name is Adam Perez. My favorite memory is Jeff Bagwell's song coming out. What was that again?
Gerald?
Ozzy Osbourne, that's right.
Yeah.
Crazy Train. Crazy Train, Ozzy Osbourne. Man, my favorite.
My name's Clark Griswold, born and raised Houston, Texas. My favorite memory was when my father ripped his pants by catching a Ken Caminiti foul ball. The realest. Thank you.
Danny Hernandez. I got a chance to play in the Dome soccer match one day for preseason. Years ago. I don't remember what year.
I'm Daryl, and my favorite memory is we came to see Elvis Presley. My wife went down to catch his scarf, and he threw it towards her, and right when he did, some other girl reached out and grabbed it from her.
My name is Russell Womack. My favorite Astrodome memory is seeing Gravedigger for the first time at 7 years old. It was awesome, a.k.a. Jossum, if you're a shark. All right, thanks.
My name is Mike Garza. My son Caleb. My favorite Astrodome memory is just coming to the Astrodome, coming to Minute Maid Park. But my favorite Astrodome memory is coming here with my dad at his age. Thank you.
My name is Marvy Gibbs.
I'm Craig Fichon.
From San Leon. And one of my favorite memories is seeing Elvis in the Dome and, of course, the pep rally.
My favorite memory is seeing Roy Rogers, and I got to pet Trigger. And I wouldn't wash my hands for about 3 days, and my mother got mad about it.
My name is Victor Galindo, and my favorite memory of the Dome probably had to be in 1998 when they clinched the National League Central Division. They actually let people onto the Astrodome after it was all clear, and we got to celebrate in the pitcher's mound and got to get the sand and everything. It was really cool. That probably got to be my favorite memory of all time at the Astrodome.
Okay, I'm CJ Yeoman. My favorite memory of the Astrodome is seeing Bob Aspromonte have a Grand Slam home run here in about 1966.
My name is Victor Washington, and I'm from Houston, Texas. My favorite memory of the Astrodome is that I was born in 54. It opened in 65. I was 10 years old. I saw the movie Selma. This is the first stadium that was open, non-discrimination. I got to give a credit to Judge Hoffines and the city leaders back in that day in 1965 when Selma, I saw the movie Selma, and I was 10 years old. And this got a lot of history, and please don't tear it down.
Hi, my name is Kelly Ramon. My favorite memory of the Astrodome was whenever I was 5 or 4 years old. I came and watched the Astros play when I was, it was back in 97. And I'll never forget that day because I think one or two Astro games I've ever been to, and it was pretty great. It was pretty much my childhood, basically, coming to the game. So, ready?
Mm-hmm. My name is Ken Smith. What I remember is watching Warren Moon, Kenny Stabler, Earl Campbell, and the Oilers play in here. We sure do miss them.
Hi, my name is Mike. Love you, Blue.
My name is Mark Goldberg. I'm a native Houstonian, so I remember when the Dome was open. I really remember the hostesses wearing these space cadet outfits. It was really neat. One of the things I was just thinking about is that they used to allow smoking in the Dome when it just opened. I'm glad they stopped that practice. But I hope they save the Dome. It's an iconic symbol of the city of Houston, much like the Eiffel Tower. And when people see a model of the Dome, they think of Houston. So we need to, that's probably the only symbol we have, so we need to keep it. Thank you. Thank you.
How you doing? My name is Michael Murphy, and I grew up here in Houston, and this stadium is where I spent a lot of my childhood. And, you know, it's a shame that it's in such a disarray, but it's a wonderful memories. My favorite memory has to be when the Oilers played the Kansas City Chiefs in the playoff game, which they lost, but my parents surprised me with tickets for my birthday, and we sat up in the nosebleeds, but I still remember wearing the Oilers pom-poms in my hat, so what a great place.
Gerald, okay, the first one is when the first game, real game, the Astros played, they announced in the seventh inning, they announced over the PA that would so-and-so with the license plate, would the one with the license plate number, please come to the west gate, your car is still running. And then when the first football game was in here, it was like 5 minutes left in the fourth quarter, they come on the loudspeaker and said, would Mr. So-and-so please come to the west gate, your wife says you have the tickets.
Randy Pollock, my first memory of the Dome would be 67-68. My dad used to drive us and the family up from Corpus to attend Astros games. And then I became a father and brought mine up here. And they were born in 86. She's got an 86 jersey on. And we've been Astros fans and fans of the Dome ever since. Thank you very much.
James Mitchell, 1994, Miss Reba McIntyre for the Houston Livestock Show and Rodeo.
And I'm Dariel. I just remember coming to the game. I'm so young to remember.
Hey, my name is Jay, and I think the best thing of this thing was, I don't know, when Selena, I guess, came through, right? That was a bomb right there. All right, appreciate that.
My name is Jera Martin, and I never will forget seeing Elvis Presley in this Astrodome in 1973.
Jonathan Cook, I'll never forget the Houston Oilers winning 11 games in a row and Buddy Ryan punching Kevin Gilbride at halftime of the Jets game to end the season.
My name is William Bickle. My favorite memory in here was being able to run the bases when I was about 6 years old and getting pictures with Jose Cruz and Bill Doran.
So what year was that?
God, that had to have been 85.
Hi, I'm Dana, and I remember coming to the Astrodome for a rodeo and being here with FFA. Thanks.
Yeah, my name is Nick, and I love this Astrodome. I love it very much. Thank you.
My name is Steve McCon. I'm 35 years old. I love this place. I don't have one memory. I have many memories. This place is so dear, dear to me. And I thank all these people for letting us do this today. And I appreciate it. Thank you, sir.
Mike Dudas, Galveston, Texas. My favorite memory is being an Astro buddy back in the early 70s and just practically living here at the Astrodome going to the Astros games. So that's my favorite memory.
What years were that?
In the early 70s, probably like 71 through 74.
Hi, I'm Rachel, and this is a big shout out to my dad, who's a big Astros fan and a really big supporter of the Astrodome. I'm here for him, and I can't wait to see what it's all about.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm Mike Torres. Favorite moment was watching us lose to Buffalo in the playoffs. It was a heartbreaking moment, but I'll never forget it. See y'all later.
Ed Rumsey, when I was partially sighted, I had the great fortune of being in the Astrodome at an Astros game, and it was one of the incredible things that I was able to see. It was an amazing building, and now I'm totally blind. I'm so grateful to have seen the Astrodome and its glory, and we definitely need to preserve this eighth wonder of the world. It's an amazing architectural achievement that definitely needs to be kept for the history of Houston.
Yeah, my name is Clarence Ledbetter, and I was there at the second game of the Dome. I got a baseball here that was signed by Judge Hoffines and Graydon McLean and also McMullen. And I was the barber that had the barbershop here in the Astrodome. And had a barbershop over at the Astor Village Hotel, and Judge Hoffines and I were just really close friends. Thank you.
How you doing? I'm Javon Burleson from Houston, Texas. I remember going to Galena Park Elementary in middle school, and we took a tour of the Astrodome and got to meet the players. Thanks to Coach Bartell. What's up to everybody in Houston? Have a great day.
I was there on opening day in 1965. Give me your name. Neil Sarahan. Favorite day, 1968, January, I think, UCLA loses to U of H Cougars.
My first concert here was Elvis Presley in 1973.
All right, give your name.
I am the Dave.
Hey, I'm Alex. My favorite memory of the Astrodome is when Lance Berkman hit a grand slam. The energy was amazing. It was the best moment of my childhood. Thank you.
My name is Greg Nino. My favorite experience is watching Glenn Davis hit home runs out of this dome right here. And this is my friend
Alan DeBarberis. And I watched Nolan Ryan pitch here. It was incredible. This is my favorite stadium. We had season tickets for years in this stadium. Long live the Astros and long live Nolan Ryan.
Yeah, it's like that.
Jim and Cody Greenwood, we were at the first baseball game played in the Astrodome on April 9th of 1965. Saw Mickey Mantle hit the home run, saw Nellie Fox knock in the winning run for the Astros. She came on crutches because she'd broken her leg skiing with four kids at home.
Hi, I'm Paul Merriman, and my favorite memory is when they used to give away free beer when the Astros would hit a home run on an even-numbered minute or strike another player out, a targeted guy. And one time they did when I was there, and they ended up giving out beers all over the place to everybody. And even though I was 19, I just took two just because I wanted to participate. And the funny thing is, the guy that was the pitching for the Astros, he waited. He got two strikes on the odd number minute, waited until it was an even number minute, and then charged the mound, threw the third strike, and everybody in the dome charged the concession stands, and we all got free beer for the rest of the game. You could never have that again today, I can guarantee you that. Beer's too expensive and too many drunks. Thank you.
Hi, my name is Laura Wisnowski, and one of my favorite memories of the Houston Astrodome is seeing New Kids on the Block, 1990 Magic Summer Tour. Go Joey!
Hey, what's up? This is Anthony Moody here at Houston Astrodome. Opened 1965, 50th anniversary. You had Elvis, Evel Knievel, Selena, The Rock versus Stone Cold. I was here in 2001 when it was an all-new attendance record. 67,925 packed this place. The biggest room in the world, over 365,000 feet of column-free space. This is a huge memory. Keep it going, guys. Okay, this is a big deal. Everyone, like whenever we walked on the moon in 1969, we celebrated it right here. Okay, keep the dome going forever, guys. All right, love you. Bye.